Vice Mayor Cadiz, magandang umaga po sa inyo.
Magandang umaga po. Maraming salamat sa pagkakataon na ito na mahinapuin po namin ang aming mga concerns sa mga tungkol po sa aming minamahal na mga na bayan, lungsod ng Marikina.
Vice Mayor, ano na ang sitwasyon sa Marikina ngayon? Ang aming reporter just a couple of minutes ago, sir, I hope you don't mind, is that kahit papano bumaba na po yung level ng tubig sa Marikina River, although still beyond critical level, sir.
Opo. Kanina madaling araw, biglang tumaas po ang ilog Marikina by about 2 meters, ano po. And it reached to a height of about 20.6 meters. And gradually, buwababa na po ang ilog. But alam nyo po, napaka-liit lang ang pagbaba. Siguro mga 0.3 to 0.4 of a meter lang.
Mm-hmm.
So, as of latest data, 20.2 meters na po ang lalim ng aming ilog.
Opo. At ang normal level is what again, Vice Mayor? Is it 15?
Pardon?
Ang ano ho yung safe na level ng tubig sa Marikina?
Well,
is it 15?
The level is 15 meters below 15 meters above sea level.
Opo.
Pagka umabot po ng 15 meters, first alarm po yan.
Mm-hmm.
Then 16 meters, second alarm. 17 meters, third alarm.
Right.
8 meters, fourth alarm. Then 19 meters, critical.
So, okay.
Kaya we already underwent these processes and we alarmed the people ready to evacuate from low-lying and risky areas.
Opo, sabi nga po nila that there have been various calls para palikasin po yung mga residente sometime Thursday morning, kanina umaga nga po, dahil tumaas na naman ang tubig dyan sa Marikina River. I believe sinasabi nga dun sa nasa paligid ay sinabihan na patuloy daw yung pagkalembang nung mga kampana.
Simbahan. No?
Mga
kampana ng simbahan.
That's right,
tama
sir.
Tama po yan.
So,
we employed every means to warn the people.
That's right. I understand, Vice Mayor, kahit po si Mahar Lagmay, yung project director po ng Project NOAA, was actually saying, wake up now and move away from the low-lying areas along Marikina River, including Tumana and Providence. Okay, let's go to Providence, sir. I understand meron pa po mga residente that need rescuing dyan po sa Providence Village.
Opo, there are some kasi nga po they thought that they will be safe inside their houses, but they finally realized that the best, the safest place now is the designated evacuation center.
Mm-hmm.
Kaya nga, ito na naman, before it's too late.
Yes, sir.
Now, they are calling us to rescue them.
Opo.
But you know, there should be no rescue operation at all if people cooperated. If people evacuated, if people are all inside the evacuation centers,
mm-hmm.
there should be no rescues at all. Kaya nga, we are always thinking.
Paano na kaya masosolusyonan yan, Vice Mayor? That's an age-old problem. I mean, it just doesn't happen in Marikina. It happens everywhere. Yung tao talaga, una-una, isipin nila, di naman siguro tatamaan na may second floor naman ako. That's a normal perception of people. Yung number two, yung pong nakatira sa tabing ilog, sasabihin nila, nakikita naman namin kapag nakita na namin yung tubig, tumama dito at a certain level, tsaka na kami lilikas. Yung bang ganun, Vice Mayor, meron silang sari-sariling mga paniniwala at yung kung kailan sila dapat magsilikas.
Opo. Alam niyo po, I fully agree with you. Kaya nga maski si Pinoy, ayaw niya na siguro eh. Ayaw nang baka. Ang gusto ni Pinoy sigurado.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Kami nakakasigurado kami na ang pinaka ligtas sa lugar ay yung pong evacuation center namin.
Opo.
Kaya nga kami nananawagan sa aming kababayan. Yun naman ay mangilan-ngilan na lang na talagang sila po ay sumunod sa mga direktiba ng aming pamahalaan. Ang pamahalaan lungsod ng Marikina ay wala nang inisip kundi iligtas ang buhay ng aming mga constituente po.
So, ano po ang problem areas niyo pa rin that you're experiencing right now? Providence is still a problem, sir.
Yes.
Okay.
Provident is always a problem now.
Okay.
Malanday, mm-hmm. Nangka, Tumana, IVS, UBB of Barangka. These are our critical areas, mm-hmm. that we really identify.
Opo.
Kaya nga, we have this hazard map and we distributed it to all the DDRRMC, yung po sa barangay, for the communities to know that when to react, how to properly react,
uh-huh.
when to go during times of floods.
Okay. So, Vice Mayor, yung balikan ko lang po yung Marikina River, ano? Bahagyang bumaba, pero beyond critical level pa rin po.
Yung, yes, ano still ho, critical level.
Opo. Ano ho ba yung reports na nakukuha nyo doon sa mga tao? Nagsibalikan na ho ba sila dahil baka maganda po ang panahon ngayon? Alam nyo naman, minsan gumaganda yung panahon. Pagkatapos ng isa o dalawang oras, bigla na naman pong babagsak ang malakas na ulan. Ano, what word are you getting from the ground? Nagsisibalikan na ho ba ang inyong mga constituents?
You know, Habagat is really fickle-minded. Eh, paiba-iba ang isip. Minsan, papakita si araw. Minsan, mm-hmm. Tataktan at bubuhos ng ulan. And these are lessons learned. I hope that our dear kababayan finally will heed the call of the government. Kung we decide to evacuate, they should follow.
Mm-hmm.
If we decide for them not to go back, they should follow. We are always thinking of the best way for our constituent.
Mm-hmm.
But again, sometimes people, you know, are really very hard-headed. That's the way it is. So. Mm-hmm. We really have to bear it out.
Okay.
We really have to play like a father.
Let's just look long-term for now, Vice Mayor. Doon po sa inyong mga kababayan na nakatira sa tabing ilog, ano ho ba ang plano ninyo hinggil sa kanila? Dahil, to my mind, and please correct me if I'm wrong, sir, sila ho ang unang posibleng matamaan, maapektuhan, madamay.
Yes.
Sakaling obviously tumaas po ang Marikina River. Unang-una, ilan pa ho ba silang nandyan? At meron ho bang long-term plan talaga ang gobyerno ng Marikina para sa kanila?
Yes, we are thinking of adaptation. We are now planning to pass a law wherein we will require all houses being built in bigger areas to have 2 or 3 story levels.
Mm-hmm.
This is one of the climate change adaptation that we are thinking of. Of course, one of the possibility also is for them to be relocated.
Yes.
To higher ground.
Mm-mm-mm.
And this is the local initiatives that we can do. To really provide a long-term solution for this problem. But of course, we are also appealing to the national authorities to do something about the state of Marikina River. If you have to plant trees in the watershed area,
mm-hmm.
to control flooding, so be it. If we have to dredge the river, we must do it. If we have to remove the encroachment, then this must be done to really safeguard our the residents living along Marikina River.
Vice Mayor, are there plans for the president to make his way over to Marikina today?
Yes. In fact, I'm just maybe 10 cars ahead of him now.
Ah, okay. Nandiyan na po si Presidente.
Yes, he's right now in Marikina.
Ah, okay. Yes. All right. Ano ho ang plano? Iikutin lang po ang Marikina. Ipapakita po ninyo ang Marikina at ano po yung pagtama ng habagat sa inyong area, sir?
Pardon?
Ano ho ang plano ng presidente dyan?
Well, of course, he will comfort our constituents,
mm-hmm.
and provide the immediate needs for them. But also, of course, We are hopeful that he will divulge to us the final plans of the government to solve these recurring flood problems in the city of Marikina.
Exactly, sir. All right. That's what we wanted to hear. So in the meantime, sir, we'll let you go. I know you have to be with the president right now. Thank you for taking our call, Vice Mayor Fabian.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
All right, the president already, Ron, is in Marikina. We were actually supposed to have the vice mayor here in the studio
today,
but obviously he has to stay in Marikina to, well, of course, welcome the president and take him around. Two very important things he said, of course, is that the president is there, number one, to comfort and give relief goods, possibly to the residents, and number two, to look at the local government's plan for a long-term plan for Marikina, which they would possibly, certainly show the president.
But we've been talking to a number of Marikina officials in the past few days, and part of their reforestation, part of the long-term plan is reforestation. This is according to Congressman Miro Quimbo. But if they are going to do that, They should have started a long time ago. I mean, if long-term plans, it would take years before those things can be put up and will, and the residents feeling the benefit of those long-term plans. But the last time we talked to Miro Quimbo, he said that DPWH is still studying proposals for a longer-term plan for Marikina. Yeah.
Well, you know, sadly and unfortunately, it takes time.
Right.
You have so many government agencies busying themselves with so many things also. But again, what's important is, you're right, a long-term plan for Marikina, not just Marikina, and other areas, you know, even in Navotas, because I was there last week. You know, they also have long-term plans, because when you actually look at Navotas, Ron, there are two bodies of water that actually come in. Mm-hmm. That's the Manila Bay and the Marikina Navotas River. So dalawa yan.
That's right.
Na posibleng pumasok doon sa mga kabahayan in some parts of Navotas. That's what happens there. So the mayor was saying, Mayor John Ray Tianco was actually saying, in the Manila Bay area, kasi actually when you see the water on, biglang nandito na yung mga bahay. Pag mag-high tide yan at mag-overflow o humampas yung malakas na hangin at tubig, pupunta na yan sa mga residente.
Pasok na kagad.
They want to put a seawall. Mm-hmm. But that's in coordination also with another government agency, because they cannot do this alone. The local government can't actually do that alone.
What we have seen actually in these areas that encounter flooding every time there's even a small amount of rain is their disaster preparedness.
Mm-mm.
Medyo nakikita naman natin na sanay na sila. Like in Marikina, a lot of people have we have cameras focused on the amount of the height of the Marikina River already.
Right.
Every time it rains,
the height of the Marikina River, the height of
the
Mesa Dam.
That's right.
Yeah.
All
right. We continue, of course, our weather watch here on ANC. Moving on, floods in Bataan have left 4 people dead and. All right, we'll get to that report a little later on in the newscast. All right, we have Bataan back. Let's get the latest from there, from Nevi Calma. Nevi.